I've made a couple videos now where I try to shrink existing, like, classic Sims builds. I rebuilt the goth family house, but tiny, then the land grab house, but tiny, and now today we go into Del Sol Valley, where we will try to rebuild Judith Ward's house, but tiny. I am sure you all recognize this monstrosity. But basically the goal is to try and recreate this home on a significantly smaller scale. I'll link the past two videos I did down below so you can see. But basically, the land grab house shrunk. Still looks the same, same idea, same color scheme. Tried to get all the classic bits, but smaller. And now today we do it again with Judith. So quick overview of her house. The outside is absolutely atrocious. I think it's important to note how there's like these weird bump outs. We'll try to recreate that as well. The inside is massive. I think one of the most important parts is that it has this like two sides thing going on to it where they have like the darker rooms on the left and then this like brighter pink and blue room on the right. So we'll try and recreate that as well. It's only a two bedroom house. It seems massive, but it's not actually that big. I mean, it's big, but it's empty. So it shouldn't be too hard to shrink. I think we should prioritize having an office because they do have two offices with that same like light and dark color scheme. And I want to try and recreate some of the flooring, maybe have like a big open entryway like this. I don't know. We'll figure it out. You know what? If anyone deserves to have their ego shrunk, it is Judith Ward. And that's what she's getting right now. I'm gonna try to keep it a tiny home, but it's okay if it goes over like the actual tiny home lot size. I've realized because I really wanted to have that like balcony on the land grab house and I couldn't do it because I didn't have enough floor tiles, but I feel like as long as the actual house is small, it's fine, right? I mean, anything smaller than her current house is tiny, so at least by her standards. Okay, it's basically a big long rectangle. Oh my god, it's not gonna be a tiny house. There's no way. Especially if we want to have like the balcony that they have. Okay, we're shrinking to an extremely small scale. I think this is fine. Obviously, it's not gonna be a tiny house anymore. I think it needs to be wider. Because like the actual house is so long and skinny, I think we need to have that. This is horrible. Oh god. I might make the walls short too. Something about the walls being tall is like throwing it off, you know? Okay, I got some columns. I painted the exterior. I think it's starting to make sense. I realize also that there has to be floor tiles up here, which means this totally could not be a tiny house because these all count as extra tiles. And just like the upstairs would be too big to be a tiny house. Just that fake room would like disqualify this from being a tiny home as far as the game is concerned. But I don't mind too much because at least we have like the look of it, you know? Okay. We have these windows here. Wait, I'm realizing on the actual picture, I didn't even notice this before, but they're different. It's not even symmetrical. Like they're, wait, okay. So there's like a staircase over here. All right, I'm telling you, the more you look into these kind of builds, the worse they feel. Like the more you think about it, the worse it gets. I feel like it probably, I don't want to make it bigger because it's supposed to be tiny, but I feel like this needs to be bigger. It's like a necessity. Yeah, no, that makes a lot more sense. The awning. There's also supposed to be flower boxes. No, I like it. I do. I think it looks really nice. This is a really nice house. Oh, you're gonna hate this, but the front door. Look, I swear to you, I'm not kidding. Look at the front door. Okay, I guess it's brown, not black. I think this is probably before they had the update to make black windows and doors, right? And then there was like a little small window. Okay, I think I need to scoot it forward on the lot a little bit. Do you know what else is so weird? The landscaping doesn't make any sense. They're supposed to be like here. They're supposed to be like some wide ones, but obviously our house is very skinny. Like this wall in real life is like significantly bigger, right? So we'll just do the one. And then they just like lined it up. This feels like such an odd choice to me. I don't really understand why it was done. Okay, they also have like some of these. Of course, a couple trees, including a pink one. Wow, looking good. I guess maybe it should be closer because like realistically the scale would be like that more. Okay, there's the front of the house. Oh wait, sorry, one more. One more. I'm gonna size the chimneys down because it's supposed to be tiny. It's so ugly. Why? Who built this? It hurts my feelings. Okay, the back of the house. You know how they have that like cutout, right? On the inside. I'm telling you, when you start breaking down these Sims builds into like more detail, you really realize how ugly they are. I don't think you would have known. I'm not sure you would have noticed. But then you try and do it on a bigger scale, and all of a sudden, like, all these little mistakes they do don't make sense. Like, for example, obviously ours is a lot smaller, but these two sides are the same size in real life. The right side has two windows, and the left side has one. We can't fit two windows, so we can't do that. But, like, even that is asymmetrical, but it's a symmetrical house. It's infuriating. Like, whose idea was that? Who built this? Who did this to me? There's, like, little... The little lavender plants are so weird. Do you know what else? The windows are different colors on the top and bottom, and also asymmetrical. Wow. And there's no windows on the inside, just like little doors. Okay, that is the back of the house. Wait, did my my chimneys are gone. Come back. Who? I did not give you permission to delete my chimneys. All right, let's try to think this through, because the floor plan is slightly different in real life versus our tiny one. So I guess we know that these are probably gonna be bathrooms, right? We can try our best to have the kitchen over here. We could also close it off on purpose. You know, we can try to keep the entryway a big entryway, have a living room on that side, and then maybe try to have like the dining room here, or just a big piano like they have. I'm sorry that it has to be like this. See, they get nice arches and a really pretty room. We get this, but that's all right. It looks really nice. I like it. It's really not even that tiny of a house. Like, this is not that small. What if, wait, because remember how the back had like these plants? What if I size them down though, so that we can still have the plants like they do, but they fit to the scale? Okay, I'm sorry, I'm getting distracted. It's floor plan time. Like that. See, we still have the open thing as like an ode to the original. I don't know what I'm doing. See, in my head, I was just thinking we could have two bedrooms and two bathrooms. Wait, you know how like the actual build has that hole in the middle of the floor? We just put a random one right there. It doesn't make any sense. Obviously the big house has like a fancy square one, but ours is just this little teeny one. Oh, maybe I'll make, wait, because we don't have an office. Maybe I'll make the downstairs bathroom into the office just so that we can say we have one. Because there's already two bathrooms upstairs. We probably don't need to have another one. Wow. This is really quite something. I'm gonna keep the piano, actually. Yeah, that's perfect. Looks really good. To be honest with you, I didn't really know this house as well as I knew like the goth and land grab houses. Like when I was trying to rebuild those, it was really easy for me. This one does not come as naturally. It's a little bit different than I'm used to. In case you hadn't noticed, I don't exactly frequent Judith Ward's home. Yes, shocking, I know. So I have to look at the reference photos a lot more often. I think that's right. I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be windows on the sides of this. And I can't really put much furniture in the rest of the entryway, so we might as well just get more windows. Like, we can't really have anything else, so. May as well just embrace the window situation. The more I look at the house, the more, like, upset it makes me feel. Okay, I swear to you, they have this couch in this color right here. But I might get the smaller one. Oh no. No. Well, at least it fits. Oh my god. It's so ugly. They have a fireplace too, but we can't really fit it. Probably get a smaller one. Maybe I'll put the smaller one. I wonder how much this house is gonna cost, because it's gonna be so tiny and yet somehow also cost like hundreds of thousands of simoleons. Oh, they have knight statues. Couple of gold ones in the entryway. Obviously they aren't in these exact places, but the entryway and ours is a bit different than the real one, so we'll have to take some creative liberty here. They also have two staircases in the real entryway, and I don't know if that's gonna happen in our house. We can barely fit one. I think they have this color counter in here. Maybe we just have the cabinets on the back wall and then put a dining table so that we can have both. Oh, they don't have upper cabinets. I guess rich people don't have to store things. I don't know. Okay, in the real build, the sink is centered on this wall. So at least we can have that be accurate, right? Maybe we'll have the fridge and stove on opposite ends. Wow, that's beautiful. Also this table. I'm not sure if this room is functional. I'm not gonna lie. I don't know if you can walk in and enter this room. That's not my problem though. Those are the right flowers. Look at how close the flowers are to the- This is horrible. This room is so like tight. Okay, let's work on the office now. I guess office is a strong word. Maybe I'll get rid of the patio door because there's a door to it from over here. Just so that we can fit a desk in here. You know what? They have this bookcase in the actual one. Maybe I'll try and size it down and fit it. Oh, no. Look, we can make this work, because we can get the desk off-centered. They don't have a computer or anything, so all it has to do is look like that. Wow. There also isn't anything in the backyard, by the way. Like, I didn't just leave that out. It just stops. You have to admit, though, this house does look a lot better when it's smaller than when it's bigger. It doesn't look good still, but it does, like, objectively look better. There's, like, two of these little dog statues, too. Okay.
I like the downstairs.
Now, upstairs, the hallway's just empty. And then, of course, we have the two different bedrooms. Let's start with the pink one. Okay. Blue carpet, that wallpaper. We have the blue carpet, and then it's like that swatch of wallpaper. The bed's not gonna fit in here. Maybe we just make it so you can't access. Listen, it doesn't have to function. I am making the executive decision that the house does not have to be functional. Also, there's just one lamp. Not on both sides, just the one side. There's nothing on the other side for whatever reason. And of course we have to use the nasty Get Famous bathroom stuff. No offense to the Get Famous bathroom stuff. It just is, it's a lot is all. You know, it's a bit much. I guess it could be called. I think the other side's the same, but it has like tile and it's just darker. Yeah, like that. Oh my God. You know, I told you we were gonna break the budget with this. It's not because of like regular things. It's because the toilet costs 5,000 simoleons. The house is gonna be like $1 million and it's because of the toilet. Please, everyone close your eyes. You don't wanna see this. I don't recommend looking at this room because it might hurt your feelings. And I mean that because I'm not making this up. This is what it's supposed to look like. Okay, finishing touches. Yet again, the one lamp and nothing else. And that, my friends, is Judith Ward's house, but tiny. I'll put this on the gallery for you. I don't know why you'd want it, but just in case you do want it, you can have it. Okay, I brought back the real house because I want to compare it. Honestly, I don't think we did so bad. We don't have any curtains and we don't have any like big paintings or anything. That's because we made our short wall height so the curtains wouldn't fit. And obviously, you know, the flooring's never gonna look as good. Because we don't have a lot of space. But I think like color scheme wise and stuff, I mean, we copied it, so it has to be right. I don't think we did so bad. We did not, in fact, get the money vault. But you know, the money vault's about the same size as the house. Like, that's the size of our bedrooms. So we probably couldn't have done that. Honestly, the bedroom is bigger than the entire house is. I still think ours is better. I hate to say it, Judith, but your house is really ugly. When it's shrunk, it really helps. It still is horrible looking. And it kind of makes the weird parts really stand out. But I mean, I like the inside. I think the next thing I'm gonna try to shrink is the museum in Del Sol Valley. I must warn you again to please shield your eyes. This is not for the faint of heart. But the next thing I'm gonna try and rebuild small is this. But if you have any other suggestions for lots that you think I should shrink, let me know. I'll do more classic EA builds and shrink them for you. But this one is next on the list. Anyway, I had fun today. I hope that you did too. And on that note, I will see all of you tomorrow. Bye, everybody. I love doing this. There's just something about it that is so much fun. I think because you get to like put yourself in their shoes and try to understand why they did what they did. And it just doesn't make sense. And it's fun to make fun of them.